has always been a dream of mine, to come to the Terra Santa, to the Holy Land, to visit all those places where Christianity was born. Well, one day, I said to myself, Guido, it's time. I packed my bags, kissed my restaurant goodbye, and came to Jerusalem. Well, here I am. Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see these things which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. Hey, Antonio, good morning. My breakfast, fresh bread, white cheese. Thank you. Today we continue to accompany Mary on her way to Bethlehem, where Jesus was born. But before that, we'll have to eat our breakfast.
Welcome to Feasts of Faith, the program that takes you on a culinary tour as we follow the story of Jesus in the Holy Land. This is Bethlehem, which means in modern Hebrew, the house of bread. When Mary's pregnancy had reached full term, Joseph took her with him from the Galilee to Bethlehem. A general census had been ordered by Caesar Augustus, and Joseph and Mary, who were both of the house of King David, had to return to the city of their forefathers.
What kind of a food would have served to an expectant mother? In those days, as today, goat milk was considered highly nutritious. Milk in those days, however, was probably always sour, like yogurt, and that because they kept them in those leather pouches. From this milk, they made cheese. You can make this cheese at home from yogurt you will buy in the supermarket, and I will show you how. Antonio, you always sleep with this guy. Take a container, give me a big piece of cloth. You take a piece of cloth, put it like this. Now we pour the milk in. Remember that I mentioned those leather pouches. Like this. Grazie, Antonio. You take the edges, like this, tie them. Mm-hmm. Bravo, sei. Non è un regalo. And you hang it to drip. It will take between 12 and 24 hours to be ready. And we can take a rest, Antonio. Please, put it up. Grazie. Oh, che bella vita. Oh. Maria. According to legend, a freshwater spring welled up under the rock upon which Mary had sat. The remnants of a 5th century church were recently excavated at this spot, and it is said a huge tree grew here until the 17th century.
the same tree which had shielded the Holy Family from the scorching sun.
And now, my friends, the cheese is ready. Beautiful, thick, white cheese. From this cheese, you make round balls like this and put them in olive oil to preserve them. You top it with a little bit of herbs. And breakfast is ready. Antonio, buon appetito.
When Joseph and Mary came to Bethlehem, they tried to rent lodgings, unsuccessfully. With no other choice, they took shelter in a cave, and that's where the baby was born. This is the Church of the Nativity in Bethlehem. Here, according to tradition, is the cave where Jesus was born. In this grotto, the Catholics set up a 14-cornered star to commemorate the 14 generations of Jesus' forebears.